Welcome back, Bikeaholics. Ryan Urlacher here, lawabidingbiker.com. Thanks for checking back in. That's right, videos by bikers, for bikers, another completely free video for you guys. And this is a big one. A lot of guys stress, the shops, the dealerships charge you a ton of money for this. And that is how to replace your final belt drive, guys. And get that belt up over the sprocket and all that. We have got you covered in this video. You're gonna love it, guys. How to remove that inner outer primary, the clutch basket, the compensator sprocket, get that inner primary out of your way. And so you can get that final belt drive. And let me tell you, you can save a ton of money. It means you can spend your money on other stuff for your bike and or heck, get out and ride and go on some trips, huh? This is, video is good. It's fair to say the final belt drives. We in this particular video, we show you a touring Dyna model. So it's good for touring Dyna, and we had a Softail on hand. There are just a few minor differences. Before we get our hands dirty, don't forget to check out all our free videos to help bikers out there on our YouTube channel and over on our website. All right, and with a T25, we're gonna get started here, and he's got five of these T25 bolts that he's gonna back out of this clutch inspection cover. All right, he's got his last one there, backing out. We'll set this aside. We're gonna have to drain the oil out of this primary is why we're taking that off. All right, and with the 5/8 socket, he's just taking the primary oil drain plug off. Got the oil pan underneath, as you can see. All right, and he's draining it. He'll inspect his O-ring. There's a little O-ring on there. If it's damaged, do a new one. If not, you can reuse it. All right, and we're removing the rider foot pegs now. You can see he's pointing at them there. It's a 5/16 inch Allen is what he's using. There's just two of them there. We'll get that up out of the way because we're gonna need it out of the way to get this inner primary cover off, or the outer primary cover, I should say. All right, and you got the second one backed out there. It's out of our way. All right, we're gonna remove the stock shifter here. And it's just a half inch, kind of clamps right on the shaft there. The way to get these off is just kind of rock it back and forth a bit, get it off the splines there. So now we're just gonna go around and remove this outer primary. It's a 3/16 inch hex head that he's using on a ratchet. And we gotta go all the way around. There's a bunch of them. So these four, he's gonna point at where he took them out of there. One, two, three, and four. Those are gonna be your long ones, guys. And just remember that. And then the rest of them are gonna be short bolts. Already got his last bolt out of the outer primary. And if it's in a older bike a little bit, it might be sealed a little bit. You might have to stick a screwdriver in between to crack it, but this is a pretty brand new bike, and so he's just taking it off. You're going to lose all your oil, so make sure you have your oil pan underneath. It's just a messy job every time we do this. There's no easy way to do it. And then if you have a nice oil pan like this, you can lay your outer primary right in there and let it drain and stuff. So there we go. So we're going to take the inner primary cover off, and we've got to remove everything here. And so step by step, he's just putting a trim tool is what that is. You can use anything. Giving himself a little space. The reason he's doing that is he's working a zip tie in there. And he's kind of snaking it around, and we're going to bring that zip tie around and tie this chain tensioner off. And the reason we want to tie it off, we'll show you, is because when we take it out, we don't want it to spring out. It'll be really hard to get back in. See, he's bringing it around there, and we're just gonna lock this thing in place, this chain tensioner, before we remove it. So that's the little trick to that, and then he can remove his trim tool out of there. And then we only put that in there so we could have a little space to get that zip tie in. All right, and there's two bolts right there. They're half inch. You just got a half inch ratchet wrench for your chain tensioner. And that's the only two bolts holding that chain tensioner in. All right, so he got both bolts out there, the chain tensioner, and it pretty much just fell right out. It's pretty easy coming out. So real quick, this is your chain tensioner. And you can look, if you have an older bike, just look at this top plastic piece for excessive wear and stuff. You could certainly, it'd be a good time to replace it if you wanted. It's an auto adjuster. This is a pretty new bike, but they'll last, the Harleys nowadays will last a long, long time. You really don't have to worry about it, but you can at least inspect it. You can, if you did accidentally not do a zip tie or something, you could. We're not going to show you, but you can actually, with your hand, clamp it back down and stuff. You could still get it in there. Just the zip tie keeps everything in a nice, neat little package for you. The other thing you're going to need, he's going to show you here. We cut a wood block There are special Harley tools for this, but we just use an old piece of wood. It's about 8 inches long cut, and you can jam it in. And that will keep it when we're taking these nuts off and stuff. It'll keep everything jammed up so we can get them off real easy. So he's going to move into the clutch nut there, and we'll get this off. And this is 11 16ths, if you're wondering. And that's your clutch adjuster there, and that's the lock nut for it. Next, you're going to need some snap ring pliers. And you'll see in that clutch assembly there, there's a snap ring. And there's two holes up there. We got to get that ring out of there, and so that's what we're going to be working on now. All right, and he just pinched those. It was actually pretty easy with snap ring pliers, and he got that ring out of there. So next we're gonna take the retaining plate out, and you can see on the out he's pointing at, it says out, so when you're putting it back together, you know that goes out, makes it very simple. He's just gonna go ahead and remove that, now that we have that retaining ring out of there. Snap ring, I should say, and that's your retaining plate. Okay, so now he's got a breaker bar, and he's got a 1 3/16 inch socket. And we're, remember that's reverse thread, and it's tight, guys. It's reverse thread, so he's going to the right to loosen that, just with that breaker bar. We had our stick in there, of course, holding it, and then it got jammed up. And he'll just back this off the rest of the way. All right, and he's just backing that off the rest of the way with his fingers there. Just because we like to reveal everything here at Lab Media, guys, this front one is regular thread. It's a T70 Torx. And we have a breaker bar, and it literally, there's so much torque on it, it took Lurch over there and Big Daddy and three hands to get that broke loose. So just understand, don't freak out if it's not coming off right away. It is a bitch to break. And again, it's regular threaded, so that's what we're removing, that bolt out of there. Okay, and here's that bolt he's finishing taking out, that Torx 70 is what it was on these new models. If you have an older model, that's what it looks like now, and he'll show us the Torx head on it. That's what they look like now. And older bikes might just have a regular bolt and you can just use a socket on it, but this is how the new ones are looking. Either way, comes apart basically the same way. Okay, now what he's doing now, once you have everything off, you grab both those guys, the compensator sprocket up front and the rear clutch basket and everything, and it's all gonna come off. Just have a nice place to set it. We've got the oil drain pan below. You see it comes off as an assembly. And you can lay it down nicely like that. All right, and so this is what everything looks like laying down. You can pretty much leave it in this configuration because we don't need to break this for this project, break it down any further. All right, half inch socket, guys. There's just those four bolts that he's gonna work on to get this inner primary. All right, so now we gotta remove the starter, and it's two bolts, guys, and you'll see right here he's pointing to one. I'll take you around the other side in a second, but we've got a specialty tool we had made. It's basically just a quarter inch hex head, and we had it welded together because we've taken these starters out before. So we wanted to show you this specialty tool we made. It's just three long hex head wrenches, quarter inch, welded together. You can have that made. If you don't, you can just get a long, they do make long ones, or you would have to remove like your battery box and stuff to get in and get access. But this makes it super handy. And so he's going to work, that's just gets in there. We don't have to remove anything to get at these. Now that we made that long extension, he just got a quarter inch ratchet on the end of it. And he's going to remove that one you can see in there. That's the one starter bolt we need to remove. And then there's another one in there too. And they can be rather tight like that. And he's got it broken loose now. So, and then the other one's just to the left of it. We'll get up in there with this wrench and get it backed out. So now he's up in there, you can see he's got his wrench still in there, and he's getting that other one on the starter where he's pointing there. Of course, he's on the other side of the bike, and Lurch has a hold of the inner primer because that's gonna release it. All right, and with those two starters bolts out, he can just push in. If you have to use a little hammer, you can, some soft hammer, not a metal to metal. But that releases the starter back in there, and he's pushing that shaft through there for the shifter, of course. And you can get your whole inner primary off there. So from here, you have your whole inner primary off, guys. The rest is a piece of cake to change your final belt drive, or your secondary, some people call it. And that's right here. Very, very simple. It's on your sprocket right here. And the way you would do that to get it off that sprocket, it's actually, they're not as tight as you think, but you just take your and loosen your axle nuts okay, your axle nut. You'll have to hold a wrench on the other side. We'll walk around on this side and just loosen them. You don't even need to take your rear wheel off. And then these are your adjusters. These right here, these Allen heads in the rear of your rear struts here, those back them in and out will bring the wheel forward or back more, and that will put extra tension on your belt. And so once you loosen those axles, nuts, you can back these off a little bit, and that will let the wheel go forward, taking the tension off the belt, and then it's just a matter of sliding it right off. Of course, you just remove your, if you have a belt guard, a couple bolts, you can see right there, you just remove that bad boy off there, and that'll allow you to just pull that belt off, and you can just slide your new one right on over. Then we have a free video for you. Head over to lawabidingbiker.com and just search for belt deflection. If you purchase this video, then it's going to be an included video file on how to adjust your belt tension correctly, because you'll want the right tension back on that. You'll just adjust it to the right tension, and again, we'll have the video file for you, or search our website, and we'll show you how to use this guide right here to get the proper tension, and all it is a matter of adjusting these right there till you get the right tension and right measurement, and then you'll tighten your axle nuts back up to the appropriate torque specifications, and you have replaced your secondary or final belt drive. The only additional thing I wanted to mention, guys, is obviously it's a solid piece of rubber. You're gonna have to just drop, and it's super easy, guys, just the bike on the wheels like it is on the ground. Don't have it jacked up or anything, but you can actually just remove right there. It's just a Torx. Remove just the bottom of this shock out of your way so that you can wrap that belt up and out of there. One thing we wanted to mention too, if you are doing it on a Softail, you will actually have to remove the rear wheel. And we have a free rear wheel removal video, lawabidingbiker.com, search for a rear wheel. We have several of them on different years bikes. But we'll include it, if you're purchasing this video, we'll include it as a file. And so you'll just have to remove your rear wheel because of the way the Softail frames are to actually get that belt off there. Hopefully you're enjoying the video. If you want to make sure that content and these free videos keep coming your way, there is a way you can support us. Head over to lawabidingbiker.com/Patreon, P-A-T-R-E-O-N. The community is growing over there. We'd like to have you involved too. There's no risk over there. You can sign up for a certain level and pay a certain amount per piece of content with a cap. Absolutely no risk. There are some benefits over there, t-shirts and a private Facebook group and some premium content. All depends on what level you sign up as. But that is a way that you can assure the content keeps coming your way. lawabidingbiker.com/Patreon, P-A-T-R-E-O-N. Of course, if you ever want to just leave a flat donation, we do accept that too and appreciate it. lawabidingbiker.com/donate. Don't forget to check out that weekly podcast, guys. It's on fire. Ton of content we're putting out. Get involved over there. It's the Law Abiding Biker Podcast. All right, let's get back into your video. All right, and we're replacing this front gasket. Never reused this, guys, for the inner primary, and put a little light lube on it. We're just using some synthetic oil, and then he'll get that back in position. Again, not a gasket you want to reuse. Make sure you get a new one if you're doing this project. So they make special tools to remove this oil seal ring. You don't need it. Just grab a block of wood or something like we have in a open-end wrench, and you just kind of pry around, guys. You just move the wrench around, and it'll start breaking loose, and you're just going to move around and do that. See, like that? Pops out pretty easy, and then we'll put the new one in. You always want to replace this when you're doing your inner primary. All right, so he's got his new oil seal right there, and it says oil side down. That's the oil side, so that's the side that's going to go down. First thing he's doing is just grabbing some synthetic, lubing it up so it goes in nice and easy. That's kind of the flat side, that, and it says oil side down, so he's going to flip it over and put it in that way because that's the side that faces the primary to keep all the oil in. And just press it down in there with good pressure. All right, we've got the new oil seal gasket in there, and we're putting the inner primary back on. That's actually the gasket we already showed you guys that we put. That's a new gasket up there. And then we just did the oil seal little rubber ring and just line everything back up on the shafts like so. Lurch is on the backside. They're doing this together, and he's manipulating the starter so they can kind of get, it takes a little finesse to get all the holes and the starter line back up. Just be patient with it, and they're just working together to make that happen. Okay, so what we're doing now is they're lining stuff up. They got the starter lined up there, you can see. Lurch is just working from the backside there. He's just going to get these started. It's easier. We haven't bolted down the inner primary yet. We're just getting those starter bolts, started, and then we'll line the front and make sure this gasket is lined up and stuff. Then we'll go back and crank the starter down. Okay, so Rick's just going around and putting the five bolts back in the inner primary. Just getting them started. He's not cranking them down yet because there is a sequence and there's torque specifications that need to be done on these. He's just getting everything started and kind of just snugged down a little bit right now. So when you're tightening these down, we've got them all snugged down, but there's a sequence that we're going to torque them. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so that's what he's doing right now is he's got his torque wrench, 26 to 28 foot-pounds on this particular year and model. Look your specs up. Make sure you're doing it right. And he's got a torque wrench. He's just going to go around that sequence. Get them all snugged down. And last, don't forget to tighten your starter down because we left that. We had just snugged it. And you can get your torque specifications if you want for that. That's what Lurch is doing over here. Two bolts on that starter. All right, and we've got the clutch basket, the chain, and the compensator, engine compensator sprocket up front. You kind of just, it's pretty simple, put it back over the splines. He put the back on, now he's turning the front just a little bit until he gets it to line up right. Just manipulate it a little bit. All right, and he just manipulated that till he got everything in place. And before we slid that over the shafts, we put a little synthetic oil on it. Just rub some on with your finger. They say to do that before you put the clutch basket and the compensator sprocket back on. All right, and so he's got the, this is to tighten the clutch basket assembly back on. This is that nut we took off. It's got red Loctite in it we put in it. And he's gonna put it on there. He's gonna get it finger started. Remember, this is reverse thread, this back one, guys. And so he's gotta turn it the opposite way to get it going there. And he's just gonna get that finger tight for now. Then we'll get a socket up in there and we're going to get the front one finger started here. Okay, he's got the large bolt for the front we're putting back in. It's got red Loctite on it. And he'll get this finger started. Then we got to get this stuff, very important to torque this stuff down properly. Okay, we've got our locking block in there. So everything's jammed up. And with a torque 70, he's got his torque wrench set to 100 foot-pounds. And this is correct thread. This is not reverse thread on the front one. The rear clutch basket is reverse thread, but... So he's just first going to torque this down. We have red Loctite on that bolt, of course, to 100 foot-pounds, and that's a lot. And then we'll take it off and crank it down. There's 100 foot-pounds. So now that we've torqued it to 100 foot-pounds, they want you to back it off one half turn, which is what he's doing. And you can mark it if you want. Just get about a half turn on it, like he's doing. Now we'll adjust the wrench to 175 foot-pounds. And we're going to adjust our block the other way now because we're going to be torquing it the other way. And we're going to put the 175 foot-pounds on this front bolt. And that's what the wrench is set to right now. There we go. So 100 foot-pounds, then back it off a half turn, and then 175 foot-pounds. Okay, so this back one is reverse thread. It's a 1 3/16 inch socket, and it's 70 to 80 foot-pounds is what he's doing. He's got his block in there. Okay, and so remember this this is kind of your clutch adjustment piece, so to speak, and plate, and it does say out on it. That goes out, makes it really easy. He's going to go ahead and insert that back in. Of course, we've got everything torqued down, holding the clutch basket on there. And then he's got his retaining clip and his snap ring pliers, and he'll get that seated back up in there. All right, and that's all seated back up in there now. Now he's going to put his, this is your adjuster lock nut, half inch. He's just going to put that back on his fingers, because we actually need to adjust his clutch now before we put anything back together. So now what we're going to do is adjust the clutch down here at the clutch basket. First thing we need to do is take some tension off the clutch because we don't want to be falsely adjusting it down there. So we want some play in our lever up there, and the way you do that is just find your cable, your clutch cable, 9/16 and half inch, and then we'll just back this adjuster nut off so we can get some play, and then we'll adjust it down at the clutch basket. All right, and so with his wrenches there, he's just working on backing that off. You can see that top nut is just your, kind of your lock nut that locks the actual adjuster into place. Once he gets that off, he can just turn this bottom one, that's your actual adjuster, and he's just gonna back it off till we get a bunch of slop in the cable. And once you get some play, He's checking. We got plenty of play up there. You see all that slop? That's good. Now we know we can actually adjust it down here. So to properly adjust a Harley clutch internally at the clutch basket, pretty simple process. As you see right there is a threaded adjuster bolt, and that's a 7/32 Allen wrench is how you can tighten and loosen that. Most of it can be done with your fingers. And then the other is the actual lock nut. All that nut does is locks it in place. So what we've done at this point is back that nut out. The lock nut gives us the ability to adjust the clutch. So now we're just gonna turn the actual bolt in until you feel a little bit of resistance. And that's actually your clutch engaging there, the point of engagement. And so he's gonna show you again, the first thing you wanna do is just back it out a little bit so it's nice and loose. Now he's gonna turn it in. Just until he feels pressure, you'll feel the clutch start to seat. There we go. And once you get it in place, we're gonna use an Allen wrench. This is a nice little trick. The reason we're using instead of a socket or something, we're using that Allen wrench is because once you seat it, you back it off 1/2 turn. And we can actually tell with that wrench to the very straight up position is 1/2 turn exactly. He's gonna hold that. Now he's going to lock that in place with that lock nut. And that's an 11/16 inch wrench that he's gonna be using here. And so at the same time, you can hold your Allen and then you can wrench that down, put some good pressure on it, get it locked in place. And that is a properly adjusted Harley clutch internally. Now we're gonna move up and adjust it at the lever to see how much play and how much slack we want up there. Okay, so he's got his 9/16 1/2 inch wrench and he's gonna start adjusting the clutch at the cable. And so he's just gonna be turning that and taking the play. Again, this is just adjusting your lever and how you want, how far out you wanna let your lever before your clutch engages. And that's all personal preference depending on what kind of riding you're doing. But he's just adjusting it at this point at a base level. You can go ride and see if you like it. Take a couple wrenches with you if you want. You can get really picky about it. But a good rule of thumb for kind of how they come out of the factory is getting it tight enough. And you see he's turning it out. And that's actually tightening the cable. And the good rule of thumb is when you come up here is to have your clutch. And you can just keep reaching up here. Is just a little play, like about that much. This has got too much still. We're gonna tighten a little more, but just a hair of play before you feel it start getting tight. But this one's still pretty loose, so we're gonna take a little more out of it. And that's almost perfect where we've got it. Just a little play right there, you see? Just a little bit. And then right there, after you work out your play, is where it gets tight. And so that's pretty much how they come out of the factory, if that's what you wanna do. Again, personal preference on that. And then once you get that done, make sure you take your lock nut and lock it down on top of that adjuster by turning them in the opposite directions. And that'll keep everything set the way you want it. All right, and so what we're working on now is just a little red Loctite on the bolts, and we're gonna put this chain tensioner back in. We've got zip tied still, of course, so it's in place, ready to go. All right, and back up in with the chain tensioner. Make sure you have it the right way, like so. And I'll put his 1/2 inch bolts back up in there, get them finger started. Red Loctite on them, of course. And in with the other one. All right, and with a 1/2 inch wrench, he's got his torque wrench set to 21 to 24 foot-pounds for this particular year and model. Check yours. That's a 1/2 inch socket. And he's gonna get those torqued down. There we go. Now he can take some angle cutters and he's just gonna, that zip tie that kept everything into place for us, get that out of the way. All right, just cleaning up his primary here because he's got a brand new gasket. This is not a gasket you'd want to reuse. So make sure you get a new gasket. He's got his outer primary cover. And I'll go right back up into place with that. And he's just gonna start getting these finger tight. And remember, your long bolts go up front. He's got 4 of them there. He's gonna start with his long ones up there. And he'll just do a few around at least to get this thing held on for now. All right, so we're gonna torque this down in a sec. We've got everything finger started. We're gonna show you there's a sequence that you need to tighten these down and torque them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. That's the sequence, guys. And so we're going to go around and do that. And he's got his torque wrench set, 21 to 24 foot-pounds. And he'll go around that exact sequence we showed you and torque all these. All right, and he's just going through, getting all these to torque specifications. All right, and we're just putting synthetic, full synthetic back in here in the primary. And you'll have to check. Each bike's different depending on the model and year on how many capacities in your primary chain case. And it differs whether you take the inner. Of course, we took the inner and everything off, so it really dumped it. And make sure you have the right ounces in there. All right, so we're going to put the clutch inspection plate back on. But you see this orange gasket in here? You can replace that if you want, but we do like 10 plus oil changes without replacing those new ones. They seal up fine. Up to you. Then you're just going to get these fingers started. All right, so there's five of these T25 Torx bolts going to star pattern when you're torquing them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You want to tighten them down with even pressure. That's what he's doing. He's got his torque wrench set at 84 to 108. These can strip out easy, and a lot of guys over tighten them, so we don't use a torque wrench for everything, but these ones we definitely always use a torque wrench. So check your torque specifications, but most of them are 84 to 108. All right, and all those are appropriately torqued down.
If you're not subscribed to this YouTube channel, you are really missing out. We have a ton of videos in the works for you guys, so get subscribed. Also sign up for the free email club, lawabidingbiker.com/email club. We will shoot you an email when we come out with new free videos. Also, do not forget to check out that weekly podcast. It's the Law Abiding Biker podcast. It's heard worldwide. All right, peace out.